Hello, Mr. Negan here. Oh ho. Okay, hello. So we're back in Warcraft Total War. It's version 2.2, the latest version to be released. It was released on May 4th, 2021. Okay. So we are playing as the Naga and the Blood Elves, also known as the Sindora, in a coop campaign using the hotseat feature of Medieval Total War Kingdoms. So we are about to attack Naga, the Night Elf, inside of Nenbis, which is a large town, using the city model on the map. So it doesn't have any walls in battle. Okay, we are backed up by 3 units of Murlocs. And we will command them ourselves, and we will attack during day, I believe. Okay, so the enemy army consists of Naga herself, the bodyguard of Huntresses, and she has a unit of Wardens, elite infantry, basic Night Elf and Spearmen. It's armor upgraded, so they have the armor upgrade you can see here, made by Sulfurion, I believe. More uniform than the first armor variant. We have the Moon Strikers. They're medium archers. And we have the Moon Priestesses, elite mounted horse archers, but they are mounted on sabers instead of horses. We have the Druids of the Talon. Can transform into birds in melee and are mages in humanoid form. In human form, we have the Night Elven archers. They're basic archers, and we have the basic spearmen, the Night Elven spearmen, and the Night Elven warriors. And we have the elite Shadow Clan guardians. I believe they spawn some units when we attack the settlement through the garrison script. Okay, it's only for the AI factions and for certain regions. Okay, let's start the battle. So we have 3 generals. We have Nasiak Darkspine, Vespira Tidrat, and Demon Hunter Illidan Stormrage himself. Okay, fight the battle on the battle map. Neve Fool. My death will make little difference in the long run. Now, the scourging of this land begins. Kael'Thas, Necromancer.
The battle seems to be swinging in our favor. From such tidings does victory emerge.
Deployment. Oh, I forgot to change the weather. That sucked. This is a village. Can't really see the enemy. We haven't started the battle yet, I see. We don't need the rams. We can drop them. Our allied army is on the other side. They have the Murloc units all have Sievich officers. So we have some Murloc Tidehunters here. Oh, their captain is here. Wrath of Shara captain. Murloc slaves. Okay. They have knives and some clubs. Stone clubs. Okay. Our army. We have the sea giants. They no longer CTD. I believe these giants worked pretty well on Windows 7, but crashed on Windows 10 a few seconds after the camera centered on them. With the tool, they won't crash at all on any computer with the tool running. We have the Hydras. They are not real giants, they didn't crash before. They are infantry too, they are not based on elephants. We have some Murlocs, we have the Wrath of Shara, old bodyguard, they are just an elite infantry now. We have the Naga Sea Snakes, they could crash despite being smaller, but now they won't. We have the Dragon Turtles, they worked fine, but they could crash if you placed a mouse on the gate. I believe they have have a new projectile that makes it impossible for them to crash. Oh, here we have Illidan himself. He looked better than I thought he would. And that's because we changed the general animations to that of the Naga Medusa matriarchs, and believe Illidan might be using the same animation. That's why he looks perfect now. Or almost perfect. Unlike before when he looked bugged. So we have fixed Illidan, I didn't know that. So I was lucky with Illidan and with Nientus. He looked much better here. Now he looks almost as good as on the strat, but probably as good. We can see that he even has his feet on the ground and not below ground. So yeah, he is much better now. Illidan. Storm Rage. And he has a Demon Hunter. Bodyguard. And we have some Medusa Matriarchs here too. Bodyguards of the General, and the Generals are random versions of the Medusa Matriarchs as well, so this is a General. Medusa Matriarchs. Now the portraits are wrong because the old ones used the Rat for Shara. No, they used the female one too. So this is the other General. But they can be any of these in any battle. They spawn different versions. But I really like that Illidan looks good. Finally. I thought it was still bugged. Okay. Start the battle. UI options. We'll slide this. So we have a captain here with 503 Murlocs. We will order them to attack. They will attack immediately. The Night Elves are moving. Here we have Naisha, their custom general. Against that, what should we use? We will use Loose Formation with the Turtles. Giants. All our range units could be grouped. Swamp runners, but they are worse, so they will be their own group. Loose formation. Loose formation. Wonder where they are moving. Pause the game. They seem to be moving towards my army. So we'll send forth the swamp runners. And the spell callers. Naga sea callers, I mean. We also had Naga ambushers. They could be also a part of the Murloc force there. So the Moonstrikers have very long range. They might start firing upon us soon. Also, we don't need the Murlocs to just stand there. They will attack the Spearman, the Night Elven Spearman. We'll waste the Murlocs first.
Our cowardly allies have fled the field. They cannot be called true men.
Lose formation with Illidan as well. So our ally is already defeated. As you can see, they slaughtered the Murlocs here. The captain is running away. See, total defeat here. Our allied army is defeated. also had druids. Just charge. Don't stop. Pause the game. We need the sea crawlers to actually attack the druids. They are really dangerous. We slaughtered the murlocs here too. Our javeliners. Fucking druids. These druids are really dangerous. Send in our Naga oracles and sea witches against them. Finally they started to shoot back, fire back at the druids there. Slaughtered our troops here, OP. I almost want to change their projectile to something less powerful. They are too strong. The same projectile is in use by some other units too, like the keepers of the grove. I removed some other projectiles that were used by the priests of the Holy Light and the Arcanists and the Hermanices and Reavers, but unlike these they could be used over walls too. These can't. These are otherwise used as strong. They defeated our ambushers and murlocs. Probably killed most of our sea crawlers too. Had some swamp runners still standing. Just attacking melee. Here are our Naga oracles. They are mages. They should be much better than the others. I wonder if they have any good I don't know if they can actually hit them from there. I absolutely do not agree with them having fired will on. I forgot to change that. Attack the druids. Buildings are in the way. Yeah, no good position at all. I think we will have to leave. This wasn't a good position. We will retreat to Eldaret. They had an OP position. Retreat. Because their druids are OP. We didn't have any good position from which we could hit them. If we hold Eldaret, we can hit them from the walls and such. We'll defend. defend instead of attacking. The Night Elves are too strong. In the beginning, at least. The Naga have too weak forces at the start. We would just be crushed by those druids. We are retreating. We lost 58%. They lost 7%. We lost ambushers, we lost all the Murlocs, 3 allied Murloc units and at least 3 of our own, and then we lost ambushers and we lost most of one sea color unit and we lost most of the oracles and sea witches too. So yeah, and they only used pretty much the druids. There were some melee fighting too. They lost some of the spearmen and the moonstrikers maybe. Still, that was a big defeat. We couldn't take the area. I believe because of the garrison script that they got huge reinforcements, and the garrisons that spawn are pretty good, including druids, I believe. I might need to change the garrisons. I don't want them to have any casters in the garrison script. Certainly not druids or keepers of the grove. Anyway, we'll defend instead of attacking. In lore, Illidan would take Nendis, but it's too strong. Invade when we have way stronger forces. The problem with the garrison script is that they spawn new armies every time we attack. So we might need to add something that prevents them from spawning more than once. Here are the Satyr Shadow Stalkers. The Naga Dragon Turtles. Dragon Turtles.
Appear to be gaining the upper hand in this battle.
No good idea to attack when they have druids. So the Night Elves are the second strongest faction in the game. Infantry is really good, but it's not good when they can take them out before they even reach the enemy. We couldn't even hit the enemy with our ranged units.
This defeat is a bitter drink to swallow.
Alright, they killed 1208 men. We killed 48, really bad. Prisoners executed Night Elves. Okay, so I killed some of our prisoners there. We can recruit some new stuff. This is a trip. I think we will recruit some Medusa Matriarchs, Naga Sirens, and we could retrain some units actually. Let's retrain some Sea Callers and recruit the Matriarchs and Sirens. Other units of Murlocs in Arcoran. Okay. And that's it for now. What about this area? We've already moved. We're still upgrading settlement here. Let's go for dirt roads then, maybe. Can get a merchant here. Let's go for a merchant. And dirt roads. Alright, next end turn. Need to have them married. Okay, civil disorder in Tunkalu and Uldar. Let's sabotage something. Sabotage mission success, that's good. We took out the undead trader. Faction announcements. Pattern of Kael'Thas. Feels unappreciated. Plus one loyal, minus one loyal, plus one loyalty. Feels appreciated. Romat, monk, plus one pity, minus one purity. Okay, our spy is pretty good oversight here. Let's move this area. The Scourge is still holding Sayer Darrow. See that only Dreadlord still alive in this campaign. Commander Vermatres is outside of Hartglen with an army of Forsaken. Right. He has an army, he has a model both in battle and on the map. Galvar Pureblood is holding Hartglen, and he has mostly mercenary bandits and some elite troops of the Scarlet Crusade. Scourge Banshee, that's their spy. The Scarlet Crusade has quite the forces to an Altmore Grain there with an army. Oh, this the Scourge is moving.
Yes, Lord. Yes, my Lord. This is where we shall meet the enemy.
Just execute. Left, so one versus one, that's better. Also better. Our army is superior to their army if it's just one. Two armies they could probably win or damage the army a lot. Okay. So we moved Prince Lord to Martyrol. have to attack here. I don't really want that area. Let's move. Here we have some skeletons, let's just auto-resolve. Execute. Alright. Merge troops, we had some losses. We have a huge army here of zombies and basic skeletons. I think it's time to attack. Rate increase, Elder on Bright Wing feels appreciated. Rate increase, Elder on Bright Wing winning first. Alright.
Yes! Cross him for battle! They're going nowhere, my lord. The siege continues.
So destroy something. Let's destroy this stuff for now. Our economy is really bad. Are still minus. Not good.
Name thy enemy, Lord.
Can't leave it that army. We'll need to attack Frosthold this time. Hope they have no mage or something. Salt settlement. We have 100 vehicles. Frostborn soldiers, 3 of them. Eagles, 1. 3 Frostborn bear riders. 2 Frostborn arbalest crossbowmen. The general, an arbalest bodyguard. Save the game. Fight the battle on the battle map.
The troops are assembled. Prepare for battle. For the moment, the fortune
start
battle
deployment.
Goes. Let's pray it remains.
This is the Dwarven settlement. The the Frostborn Dwarves are holding large city, I believe. Okay. We don't need the blood shades to hold those rams. Okay, Spellbreaker can do that better. Alright, start the battle, attack the gate. Lose formation on all of these units. So This is units of Brightwing Vindicators. Let's attack the wall. Brightwing Vindicators and Kael'Thas Swordmasters, Sindori Swordmasters, okay. Here we have the bigger phoenixes. Alright. And the mounted blood knights. His name Blood Knights. The Pyre Star. Demolishers. Shouldn't crash either now. The Giant versus the Golems. Walls, we can find some crossbowmen, crossbowmen, arbalest crossbowmen.
Our men have reached the wall.
Some soldiers. So our Sindori Swordmasters have started to go up the ladders there. Same on this side. We have some oil there, throwing down our spellbreakers.
Our siege towers have reached the wall.
Good. The Sindori Swordmasters have entered the wall from the ladders. Fighting the Frostborn soldiers on the walls.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a
world. Killed 11% already. Didn't want the elite units to use the ram because their oil would take down some of them. On the walls, we can use elite infantry, that's fine. This is the only area of the Frostborn Dwarves. Minor faction. Here are their eagles, light cavalry. They are very fast, good at hunting down enemies that are fleeing. But Saki in actual battle. Here are the Brightwing Vindicators. One of the coolest looking units of the Blood Elven army.
The battering ram has done its work. Now is the time for brave hearts.
Gate is down. So tight formation and charge into the gate. Maybe the oil will kill some of them. Yeah. They'll fight
our
the eagles.
Prove their worth today. The enemy's walls belong to us now.
They've taken the wall. They still hold the gatehouse. Kill off their infantry on the walls first there. They'll fight the soldiers. These guys could move to this side. Take the gatehouse. Still held by them. Had some more units there. There they died. Let's try to move everyone. Yeah, they did have cavalry. They have the javeliners. Javelin throwers. Frostborn dwarves mounted on bears with a unique skin. We really need to take some more cities so that we can get better economy. Villages are pretty much worthless, so we needed something better. We won here as well. Good. Spellbreakers zoomed in view. Okay, but they are still holding the gatehouse. Which isn't good. One unit of Frostborn soldiers here. So I don't want to send in any units before the wall is or gatehouse is out. Good for defending too. Defending against the Scourge. So if you take this area with any of the Dwarven factions, you can get Frostborn Dwarves as mercenaries or as a regional of recruits. Alright, spellbreakers count as spearmen. But I don't trust them to fight the cavalry. This settlement is one of few with human music in Northrend.
is unwise to praise the day before.
Let's try to move back through this gatehouse. I hope it will be ours this time. This settlement is using a skin from Warhammer by beginning of the end times, but then we made the textures, so it's unique for Warcraft, but with the symbols from Warhammer. I believe even the symbols might be remade, but I'm not sure. So we remade the colors. They used to be blue, I believe, and orange. Now they are like gray and brown. All right, let's fast forward the battle on the wall.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Looking good against the infantry. Here we have the Hawkstrider Knights, the unique mount.
Battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours.
Soon the battle will be over on the wall. You killed 65%, I killed 5%.
Is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours.
Right, 68%. Finally, it's dead. Final unit soon dead. are dead. Let's move down the spellbreakers first. Gate to be ours. I don't trust it. These guys now seem to be firing towards our troops. Okay. Canceled in our golems, but they will probably be easily taken out by their javelins. Okay, we will send in some. Guardians. Maybe not. Maybe the Blood Knights.
In our favor, if we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours.
They look really good when they ride the capes like this. In the other unit of spellbreakers too. One with ram, just move in. And tight formation. Have the miracle advantage in cavalry in this battle currently. Our cavalry is superior to theirs in melee. Comes the rest of the spellbreakers. Spearman. Good. Killed 78%, they killed 9%. And more cavalry coming here. Had some units here too, crossbowmen, herbalist units. Just attack. Back and forward. entire unit, only have 30 something remaining. So Blood Knights. This model unit is named Blood Blades. We will win this. Kill their Frostborn Bear Riders. Still have some ranged units. Send in our archers against them. Do you have any other unit still alive? Any mounted unit still alive? No. Good. Let's move out with the cavalry. Archers are moving in. Handle their crossbowmen. Frostborn Arbalest. Whatever they were named. Them. Frostborn Arbalest missile unit can already fire at them. Can fire at us too from that range. Elven archers, you should be able to handle them. They also have less, they have fewer numbers than we have. 124. And a 6. Maybe not. They are killing us. They are more effective than the archers. Killed a lot of our archers already. Killed 89%, killed 14%. This Arbalest crossbowmen were better than I thought. Killed a lot of our archers. They have heavy armor. Look at their stats. 11 melee attack. And charge bonus 5, so in total 16 attack, pretty good. And 8 missile, 11 defense. Also they have can hide in long grass, bonus fighting cavalry, effective against armor. I see his armor doesn't protect against their crossbow fire. Combat bonus in woods or snow, long range missiles. Excellent morale, very good stamina. So they have a lot of bonuses, and we have combat bonus in woods, long range missiles, excellent morale. So we are worse in terms of abilities. We have 9 melee attack and 3 charge bonus. In total we have 12 attack, which is way worse than 16. We have 9 missile attack and 9 total defense. We have slightly better missile attack. They had 8, but they had better armor. So that's why we are easily killed by their fire, while we have a harder time killing them because of their thicker armor. And our armor doesn't count for because their fire penetrates armor. Well, our fire do not penetrate their armor. Three remaining. That's really bad news because the archers are really valuable against the undead scourge. It's not good that we lost so many against one unit of Frostborn Arbalest. Take longer reloading to.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Yeah, they are very effective because they penetrate the armor values of their enemy. Not that these archers had much armor anyway. I don't want to lose any more archers. Look at this body count. We lost a lot of archers. 28 and 57 remaining. Respectively. Not good. So we are sending in the Blood Knights instead. Kael'Thas, maybe they will succeed. Yeah, at least one volley. Don't stop. Continue. Spread out. Cavalry is valuable too, but I figured it would be easy to kill them with cavalry. Velo guys, bellow. Ice bellow. Manufactures, their leader is dead. Leader of the Frostborn Dwarves has fallen.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset,
But our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Good. And 9% kills, 17% allies kill. Yeah, they are doomed.
All of Christ
won the battle.
Awed by the victory we have won here today.
All right, clear victory. King Kael'Thas had 1,702 men, lost 246, and we have 1,456 remaining. We killed 981, so we killed way more than we lost. We still lost too many. And Bellow had 991 men, lost all of them, but they killed 289. Okay. And we took their capital, a large city. We will wait in the city. It's too dangerous to move out when they have many armies. Let's it's not good that we are having revolts in Uldwar. Let's move a unit. No, we won't move a unit from there. Let's try to make it the capital to see if that will help with the revolt. Okay. Let's end the turn. Trade increase, general sketches. There's one loyalty. Construction report. We have dirt roads in Ripley Strand and in the ruins of Matistra in Arkaran and in range. Big of a wooden castle upgrade completed. Okay, we have some new units. Naga Sirens in Eldaret. Status Shadow Stalkers in ruins of Matistra. Marlock Tidehunters in Arkaran. A merchant in Ripley Strand. Let's move the merchant out.
Ready to trade. Yes, that money is my lord.
Alright, we have some other units too. So we'll recruit something. Go for another Guardian of the Abyss unit. Maybe Naga Oracles. Some Murlocs here. Arkran. You're under siege here now too. Under siege. For this building, Bestiary of the Shores, to get the sea snakes. Alright, end turn, I believe. The Night Elves are attacking Nasuel, the castle. Alright, we'll fight that in real time. Deployment. I don't know how the AI will do in this segment. There's only one way in through the gate here. So we have some missile units here. Alright, let's I don't know if it's a good idea to have those in the wall. Let's move them here instead. Harlocks. They are on the wall. Alright, they will be there. They throw javelins at the enemy. Night Elves are starting to move, sending in their spearmen and their moonstrikers. Here's their general, captain probably in this battle. This is a captain, sentinel captain. We have 94 Naga ambushers. Let's fast forward this. Oh, they disappeared. We can hide anywhere. We are holding the gate. Just needed to open. Stop moving now. We need to trigger the enemy into moving there by opening the gate. Now they are moving. Their entire force. Archers disappeared. Maybe not, they just vanished, but they are still on the map. In the infantry first. We can send out our bodyguard first. Doesn't really matter. my mind. There's no reason to do that. We'll move them back here. Should start firing soon.
Walls are no longer ours. The enemy has
taken them. Yeah, the Murlocs are firing too from the walls. Alright. Let's use these guys in melee. Fire their missiles. Maybe I should have done the opposite, had the ambushers here and the Murlocs as melee troops. They will defeat the ambushers, no doubt. Just sending in their basic troops first. Building lost. Building captured by the Night Elves. No, I mean by us. We captured it again. They are moving away for some reason. Win against their warriors, I believe. Or maybe not, are we broken or something? Attack those guys, and let them enter the city. They're broken, good. Defeated their warriors, only 9 remaining. They still have their elite unit here, the bodyguard unit. They want it capped. Oh, they had a guy here. Fire at their elite troops. The javelin with the tridents. Take out as many as possible from a distance. You only have 39 remaining. Alright, we killed 49%, we killed 14%. We defeated their infantry. I'm still worried about their ranged units. on again. Four ambushers remaining. Yeah, no problem moving on the wall. Good. Oh, they are moving. Slow down the game. That's spearmen, shit. Didn't want them to have spearmen.
We are blessed. The enemy general is dead. We have sent the idiot to hell.
Let's move back. Spearmen are just standing there. Kill their captain. If we move too close to these spearmen, we will also be attacked by the moonstrikers and their arrows. Might have no choice but to move out. Oh, the moonstrikers are moving. Some of them are still on the wall. Thank you. this will trigger any movement. No, it didn't. Then just attack. The Murlocs. They are visible. Now they disappeared again. Apparent to ambush our troops. So we are firing at their spearmen. Seem to want to fire. Let's move the bodyguard here. Back, fight the Moonstrikers. I believe our bodyguard will handle those guys pretty well. Let's just attack them, the Myrmidons. Same with the amateurs, good. They aren't firing back yet. Some glitched in this back in that unit.
Only half the enemy.
Our captain and the Myrmidons started to fire, started to fight their Night Elven spear. That's good.
For the moment, the fortune of battle goes our way. Let's
we killed 82%, we killed 19%. We'll win this battle.
Our army is tiring.
Good, I destroyed the buildings. In vain. They broke. Good. Moonstrikers have run past our range units. Let's lose formation, some horn. Kill some of us. From a distance there. Alright, we reached the Moonstrikers. Now kill them in melee.
Favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours.
Good.
Praise the Almighty!
In
our
battle.
Enemy has lost the stomach to fight. We must
kill the Moonstrikers. They're running away over here. Alright, we can fast forward. So these guys have either swords or tridents.
Come back, coward!
So these are the generic captains as well. The battle's over. They fled.
By the Lord above, our foe has been much humbled.
Heroic victory.
All remember this day.
So lost 85 men.
Our most glorious victory.
Killed 485. That's really good. We killed 400 more than we lost. Alright, they killed only 96. Nashville still stands.
The day you
is ours, Lord. The
enemy attacked here too. One of the ruins. Probably I'm at something. Similar army, no archers this time, that's good to know. We only have two units, let's save. Let's fight this battle as well. Probably a village this time.
Our foes appear.
No, we upgraded the city, it's the same castle. Myrmidons and Satyr Betrayers. Start the battle. We'll move the Satyrs here. They have the first armor variation used by these spearmen. These ones too, two units of spearmen, then they have the volunteer militia. Five Saturn Betrayers. Opened up the gate to help the enemy move there. They're moving the wrong way, so they're moving all around the place. Oh, they have some troops here. Volunteers are already here. Attack the Myrmidons. Actually, no, I changed my mind. They are charging now.
God save us! The enemy have the walls!
Here's their captain.
Defense, or Central all will captain. Be lost.
And here come some Night Elven warriors to help the volunteers. Right. Our troops are better, but fewer in numbers. I think we'll win this first attack at least.
Pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
4 remaining out of 75 Satyr Betrayers. We won against the Night Elven Warriors. Alright, let's attack there. They are coming back. Alright. We'll just wait.
The enemy general is dead.
The captain died. Krildor. We easily won against these guys too. Fled into the city. Quite a few actually. They are not broken. Let's attack with the Myrmidons then. They broke through. Good. Let's kill them. Satyrs. Only 13 left. 13. Surrounded, they will be killed. Good, we won against that unit too. We have two units over here. Let's move out and attack them. Myrmidons and the captain included. And 42 of the Satyr Betrayers. We'll win this battle too, I'm pretty sure. 50% enemies killed, 23% allies killed. Yeah, we should win this. Satyr Betrayers are way faster than the Naga troops. They are really slow. Ah, now they started to move. Let's slow down. Everything to normal speed.
Only intervention by the Almighty Lord or a military genius can bring us victory from this disgrace.
So you have the, they have the miracle advantage here. Satyrs might be defeated unless the Naga come there in time. To the fire remaining. Remaining. Soon they will have a backup. The Myrmidons, 109 Myrmidons. We'll probably win now. Oh, they had another unit. Maybe not. We'll see.
Our army is tiring. Pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
Yeah, Only 18 satyrs left. We might lose this battle due to numerical disadvantage.
I pray the very even battle changes because defeat seems almost
9% enemy skill, 46% ally skill. Twelve satyrs remaining.
We have lost half of our men.
Nice. Cabin is pretty badass.
Only half the enemy force remains.
8 satyr betrayers left standing. Oh, we lost the last satyr. All the satyrs are dead. Fought to the last satyr. Enemy skill to 76% ally skill. They will probably win. Yeah, they have numerical advantage.
Pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
Alright. So we are using the M2DVP tool and its feature, which makes it possible to see colors of the enemy and the colors of the allies. The red dots are enemy colors, of course. And the green ones are ally troops are blue. Captain is still alive. past the troops. 64 remaining. Here they have 63.
Our foolish general has thrown.
Oh, the general died.
Perhaps our chances of victory
are limited. Only have 4 remaining. Let's attack them anyway. Two remaining. They haven't been broke yet. Haven't broken yet. Let's attack them. Another one there, they have 59 remaining. They are ganging up on this Myrmidon. They have 56 remaining now. And finally died. Should have one more somewhere. Here. Wonder why he is so far away. Kill 86% and they kill 99%, so they will have killed 100%. One unit has 12 remaining, the other 56. Oh, he was killed easily. Thank you.
is nothing. We fought like true men. Next time, these pigs will pay for their good luck today.
All right, we killed 414, they killed 196. We have 0 remaining, there were 132 remaining out of 501. Turn the blade, complete the circle, release me from this prison, Nerso, Lich King. They attacked again. The ruins of something. Okay, so they have some druids here too. We won't fight this in real time. We only have a myriad of units. We have lost. There's no chance there that we would win. We're back on the Sindori turn. End of turn report. Alright. Relations improved and I got good relations, okay. We have a new undead force here. We need a smaller army. Check if we can attack here. We can speak to the Scarlet Crusade. Ceasefire, trade rights, map information. We accepted. Till the cease between the Sindori, Blood Elves, and the Scarlet Crusade. Right, we can fight this battle. So, enemy army details. They have some Vargul Flesh Rippers. Vargul Flesh Rippers. Vargul Flesh Rippers. And they have a cool picture. They're pretty good. They are like the Arcane Guardians. Smaller guys. Skeleton Soldiers. Basic Troops. Myriad Champions, Elite Troops, Goals, Basic Troops, some Undead Sergeants, okay. save the game. So, feel like using the immersion mode, but we need to use the mage. Let's fight this battle. Fight the battle on the battle map. Start deployment. Can I lose formation and move them far away? And so this is Kael'Thas, king of the Blood Elves. He should be the only one with his face now. Yeah. So this one is unique to him. UI options good, they are as they should be. Okay, start the battle. Army is coming over there. Let's move there with Kael'Thas. Reinforcements, Captain Andoret. Some Arcane Guardians. We'll have shootout stands on. Blood blades there.
For the moment, the
Blood knights.
Let's pray it remains as such.
Centauri sword masters. Blood trades. And the giants. Pyre star demolishers. Arcane guardians. Viking vindicators. Some archers or elven archers. Priests of the Sun, Arcanists. Spellbreakers, Hawkstrider Knights. Need to move up my general here. We have to run. Let's hurry up. Alright, so our bodyguard is moving up here. Dead army is moving up too. We have the upper ground, which is good. Here are the Myriad champions. More of them. Even more Vorgul Flesh Rippers here. More of them. Even more. And the ordinary troops, the ghouls, skeleton soldiers, spear. Undead surgeons and such. So we placed our troops on shootout stands first. Pyrestar demolishers have entered battle. I hope we won't take out our own giants with two skies, I forgot about that. We might do that. If that's the case, we will probably have to restart the battle. Let's place them on aggressive stance instead. Shouldn't have had the priests and the other mages in the AI army. Because the AI is stupid enough to shoot their own troops. These are their giants. Should also have phoenixes in the army. Oh, the Emiria champions are taking out our Hawkstrider knights. Here are the phoenixes. They can fire. Beam. I'm just worried that our mages would take out the Pyrestar demolishers, our most powerful infantry. Phoenixes could do that too. Here we have some Arcane Guardians, the same size as the Virgos. The same. The Phoenixes, they are flying. Arcanists are firing their beams. Not good at the two guys showed up there. Fuck. Kill our own giants. We only have those. So the Pyrestar demolishers are way bigger than the others, but even giants can be taken out in one shot by siege engines and mages.
The enemy are badly bloodied.
You have the blood trades.
Praise to our Lord! Our men have slain the enemy
general! Is dead, Captain. Our true is just a captain. It doesn't really matter. The bloodshades, they jump around like this in battle. We lost 74%. Ooh, the archers are firing. Emiria champions. We kill 90% already. We need to keep the mages in a different army that we are controlling. They're still fighting some skeletons over here. their undead soldiers too. 5% enemy skill. And their ghouls. All right, we won the battle.
Victory we have won here today.
We didn't lose any of the giants or phoenixes. Good. All right. King Kael'Thas had 40 men. He lost 0 and killed 1. Captain Andrat had 1369 men. Lost 290. He killed 1320. That's good. I have 1079 remaining. Scourge has 0 remaining. They killed only 282. Pretty bad. Right. Mages could move to Kael'Thas force.
Consume the building. And your orders?
Here is a Scarlet Fleet. Alright.
Plotting course now, by the
way. Let's move the fleet towards Uldor.
Yes, my lord. Dropping anchor until morning.
Alright, let's end the turn. So the Night Elves are attacking here too.
Talk is cheap. Come face me.
We only have Murlocs there, they'll probably lose. Still the Sea, Sindori, Blood Elves and the Scarlet Crusade. Treatment report, we have Southern Shadowstalkers and Ruins of Nemtistra. Probably attack again. No point in doing anything there. They've taken two areas already. Recruit some Murloc Tidehunters. Wooden Castle upgrade here. Bloodmist Iron. Would be good. Wooden wall here. Traveler's Lodge. Priest. Let's just. I don't know. upgrade armor, maybe. Nah, we don't need that here. Ah, these units can move down.
Yes, yes, Lord. Ready to train. Orders?
Towards the city here, replace strand. So, could construct some paved roads, but I want the port. Attacking Arkram, an army. They have two units of Moon Strikers, one unit of Shadowglen Guardians, two units of Night Elven Archers, three units of Night Elven Spearmen, one unit of Ruins of the Talon. I believe it's over. Automatically resolve the battle, clear defeat. Oh, the Scourge is attacking. There is a Windrunner here. We will fight that battle. So they have one army consisting of undead trolls, skeleton spearmen, and human skeletons. That's nothing. And then they have another army. Undead soldiers, undead halberds, skeleton soldiers, zombies, undead trolls, ghouls, undead surgeons, human skeletons, skeleton raiders, skeleton archers. Okay. We are leading the balance of power. Let's say the game. And I think we will stop playing here and continue another time. So Verisa and her army will fight Captain Shabnok and Captain Kael'Thas of the Scourge. And if they win, they will take this fort and the path will be free to attack Tranquillium, another large town held by the Scourge that used to be an area of Kael'Thas. Okay, see ya.